Now let us solve the third part, that is the total surface area. Now what would be the total surface area? The total surface area, or the TSA, would be the inner curved surface area, the inner curved surface area plus the outer curved surface area plus the area of the top and the bottom surfaces. Area of top and bottom surfaces. So total surface area would be equal to the inner curved surface area plus outer curved surface area plus area of top and bottom surfaces, right? So now what would be the area of top and bottom surfaces? This area marked by red is nothing but the area that we need to find. The area marked by red is nothing but the area that we need to find, because this metal pipe, it is hollow, right? It is hollow and it has an inner diameter and an outer diameter. So the area of top and bottom would be the area that is enclosed between the inner and the outer diameter. So first of all, let me calculate the area of top and bottom surfaces. What I'm going to do is I'm going to calculate area of either top or bottom, then I'm going to multiply it by 2. So basically, total area of top and bottom, top plus bottom, would be 2 multiplied by, because it is for top and bottom both. So twice of pi r square. Now we know that the area of any circle is pi r square, right? But here we have two circles. One is the outer one having RO as the radius, and one is the inner one having RI as the radius, right? So the red marked area would be the area of the outer circle minus the area of the inner circle. So it would be pi r naught square minus pi r I square, right? Pi r naught square minus pi r I square, the area of the outer circle minus the area of the inner circle. So I can take pi also as common and write pi as 22/7 r naught square. R naught square is, I know r naught was 2.2 and r was 2 cm, 2.2 and 2 cm. So 2.2 square minus 2 square, right? So calculating 2 × 22/7, what is 2.2 square? 22 square is 484. So 2.2 square would be 4.84, right? And 2 square is 4. So 4.84 minus 4 would be nothing but 0.84. 0.84. And as we know that 84, it is a multiple of 7, so it is beneficial for us to use pi as 22/7 and not as 3.14. This goes 0.12 times, right? 7 12s are 84, so 7 into 0.12 is 0.84, right? So 2 into 12 is 24, and 24 into 22, let me calculate for you. 24 into 22 would be 8 4 8 4, that is 528. So this is 528 is nothing but 24 into 22. We need 0.24 into 22. So this will be 5.28 cm². 5.28 cm², right? So we have the areas of the inner cylinder, the outer cylinder, and the top and the bottom surfaces. The total area would be the sum of all these three areas, right? 1064.8 plus 968 plus 5.28. So let me add it for you. 1064.8, right? 968 and 5.28. So this becomes 8, 8 and 2, 10, 5, 5, 10, 18, 7 and 6, 13, 9 and 1, 10. So this becomes 2038.08 cm². This is our total surface area of the cylinders or the metal pipe, right? The total surface area of the metal pipe is 2038.08 cm², that is the area of the inner cylinder, the outer one, and the area of the top and bottom surfaces, right? The key point here was that the area of top and bottom would be calculated by using this formula, that is the area of the outer circle minus the area of the inner circle, pi r naught square minus pi r I square, right? Now let us move on to the next question, right? Let me read the question for you. The question says the ratio between the curved surface area and the total surface area of a right circular cylinder is 1:2. We are given the ratio of the curved surface area and the total surface area of a right circular cylinder. Find the ratio between the height and the radius of this cylinder. We need to find the ratio between the height and the radius of the cylinder.